Welcome back, everyone. If this is your first time checking out this week's progress on the virtual HMS Victory, welcome as well. Over the past several months, I've been painstakingly working each week to produce a virtual tour of the Victory that I'm hoping will be a way for people to interact with the ship without leaving the comforts of their home. However, if you are able to get out and see the real ship, I hope that you do so. There are a lot of small details that just don't show up in the gaming engine that I've included in the virtual model that you'll see in the walkthrough of this week's progress. I'm still going to add smaller details even if it's not so noticeable, since it's the detail that brings a certain level of realism to the project. Certain objects that you see in this week's video are still in rough stages. I've included stills from a YouTube video that I've been using for reference. If you guys are interested, I'll include a link to the video in the description if you'd like to check out the full video. As I mentioned in previous videos, there will be a demo coming soon, which I'll make available to anyone who would like to test out things and have fun exploring this great ship. Only the top four decks will be accessible in the demo, but all decks will be unlocked in the full tour. With the demo, you'll be able to not only wander the decks and look for various objects, but I'm hoping to include somehow the stories behind each of these objects and what they were used for. The final tour will have weather elements, more decks to explore, sails, and I'm hoping to add buoyancy to the ship as well. The items this week were things like rails, the stove, the anvil with the log, new gratings, a cabinet on the fore section of the deck, and a new set of walls in the foredeck area as well. I wasn't going to add these walls, but I feel that adding them created more areas to explore and help with the placement of other objects along with the scaling. You'll probably notice that some of the materials aren't quite right on certain objects. I'm still in the process of learning Unreal Engine and the way shaders are set up. The shaders are where the materials such as wood, metal, or rope are created and applied to the models. The materials themselves are created to replicate the main surfaces found on the Victory and have to be made up of textures found on mine, which are mixed together to produce the look that you see here. When I'm modeling the various parts and pieces in Blender, I also set up the shaders. That way, when the models are brought over to Unreal Engine, they have the materials already in place. However, only certain portions of the materials transfer over because the node groups are not the same. The nodes are set up to break up the various properties of the material and tells the program how each material behaves in different lighting conditions. For example, if I have something like wood planks, you would see the grooves in the wood because there's recessed areas from the grain. The light would fall on the topmost surfaces, but not so much more on the recessed areas. So that's where you plug a height image into the normal or displacement node channel. As for different node channels, you have things like roughness, which determines how shiny an object is, base, which is the color of the object, opacity, which controls the transparency, and emission, which controls whether or not the object emits light or not. Back in Blender, you can see how the model is coming along. Here you can see all the various pieces of the model. As you can see, there's a lot more details added here that don't show up in Unreal Engine. You can see some of those shaders that I had mentioned earlier and how they affect different objects. Let me know if there's anything you guys would like to see in future videos. Well, that wraps up today's video. Thank you guys for tuning in, and please feel free to like and subscribe so you don't miss any new updates. I'll see you all next week.